Okay, everyone, so thanks for joining us for this latest edition of the Cerule Training. This one is going to be about the game plan interview. And when we talk about the game plan interview, what we're really talking about is what is that process that every single new IBO entering Cerule should go into? What are the things they should know right up front that is really going to prepare them to really have success? I'll tell you, we've had a lot of success utilizing this game plan interview format here in the industry. In fact, we've seen it that the people who tend to go through this process, their growth curve is a lot sharper and a lot steeper than the growth curve of the people who don't go through it. Simply because the people who go through the game plan interview, they understand what to expect. They're not as surprised by things, and therefore they're better able to deal with the things they're going to actually encounter as they move along through their success curve here within the industry. So we're excited about this. So hopefully you have a pen and piece of paper. Watch this video as many times as you want. But let's actually get started here talking about this game plan interview process. First, we're always going to tell you the definition of success in MLM. Here's the formula for success in MLM or network marketing. Take a large group of people, teach them some simple tasks, and then you have them repeat those tasks consistently over a reasonable period of time. So large group, simple task, repeat it consistently over time. That's how you achieve success in multi-level marketing or network marketing. And you're going to see as we go through these principles, it all adds up and it all stays true to this definition. So guys, first, the purpose of this game plan interview is simple. One, we want to create the proper mindset. Right at the gate, we want you thinking properly about this, and I'm going to tell you why. Some of the things that you actually are going to do here in a network marketing business are very similar to things that you do in other types of businesses. But some of them will seem absolutely alien to you. And if you don't understand why, you won't actually adhere to the principles. So we want to explain to you some whys here so you're prepared. Number two, we want to help you set some initial goals. Also, we want to help you create an action plan. We want to lay the foundation for duplication, guys. That is critical, okay? That's very, very critical for your success. You're going to hear that term again, duplication, duplication, duplication over and over again. And we want to raise your IQ level. Now, we know what IQ means in the outside world, but within this business model, IQ means I quit. So we want to raise your I quit level. Again, a lot of times people will tell you, hey, there's only two possible outcomes. You can succeed or you can quit, right? Failure only happens when you decide to leave the game, when you decide to quit. So we want to raise that IQ level. We want to teach you some things that are going to prepare you better so your skin gets thicker, so you're more mentally prepared for what you're going to encounter here, and your I quit level goes very, very high, so you're not going to quit very, very easily. So that's the other thing we're doing is raising that IQ level. Now, the first thing I want to start off by talking to you about is this thing that we call the U factor. And here's basically the mentality. Every single person that is involved here with us in Cerule, they all have access to the same product. There's no secret product that's only for the people that we like. We all have access to the same products, right? And every single person in Cerule, we all have access to the same opportunity and pay plan. There's no secret pay plan that we only give to the people that we like. So the only variable here in the success equation, we've got the same product, the same opportunity. The only variance, the only difference is you. And that's powerful for you to understand that. Because a lot of times people will say, well, I don't know. You know, there are people making incredible amounts of money here in Cerule, and then there's other people who aren't making incredible amounts of money. So what's going on? Is there something going on behind the scenes? No, there's no secrets going on behind the scenes. It's the U factor. And the quicker you understand that, the quicker you take the power to basically improve your business. See, if you believe that it's a product or an opportunity problem and not a you problem, then what you're ultimately saying is, only someone else has the power to help me and fix my problems and help me have success. If you actually say, hey, things aren't going well for me, so what can I learn better? What can I do better? Who can I model after? Who can I seek out for coaching and support so I can get the skills to be better at this? Then you're giving yourself now the power to go out and fix your success. So I want you to understand that throughout this process, we're going to be here to guide you. We're going to be here to support you, but we're not here to do it for you. In fact, we can't do it for you. That U factor is so critical, and we're going to actually spend some time here within this training talking about how to improve that U factor in your equation of success. Now, the next thing we're going to talk about is your why. And you know what? There's a gentleman by the name of Napoleon Hill who wrote a book in 1937 called Think and Grow Rich. And he spent 20 years interviewing the 500 wealthiest people in the world at that time. And after interviewing the 500 wealthiest people, he boiled it down to a dozen, a little bit more than a dozen key principles that they all had in common so that he could understand and put together a manual of success, if you will. And what he said was the number one ingredient that he discovered that all of these successful people shared, the number one ingredient they all shared was a burning desire. They had a big, giant reason why they wanted to be successful, and that why it drove them. So here in network marketing, what we tell you is when you're getting started in your business, you want to have a big, giant why. There's a saying that if your why is big enough, you will figure out any how. And it's absolutely true. So for some people, it's time freedom, other it's financial freedom. Some people are worried about retirement for themselves or for their parents, other people they care about. Some people want to have more of a dream lifestyle. They want to do amazing things and have amazing experiences. And other people, it's all about their family or some aspect of their family. So you need to figure out what your why is. You need to figure out what is the reason why, not just why you want to do this, but why you won't stop doing this. Why, no matter what type of obstacle you run into, there's something that you absolutely need to accomplish, and you realize this is the vehicle to help you accomplish it, so you will not be derailed. Figure that out, and you're going to be right in there with some of the most successful people in history with that burning desire. Now, the next thing I want you to understand as a person who's just getting started here with Cerule is how this system works. It hasn't changed over decades, right? It's very simple. Making a list, exposing the people on that list, following up with those people after they've been exposed, and then sorting them based off of their response. So whether they say yes, maybe, or no, what do you do with them? Now, I know that sounds simple, but obviously there's some components to it, and we're going to spend a lot of time teaching you those components. How do you really make that list? How do you code it so you're approaching the right people faster, et cetera? How do you expose people in a very simple, duplicable manner? There's only one real way to do that. That's with third-party tools, and we're going to explain to you what those are. How do you follow up? When do you follow up? What is the key to follow up? And then how do you sort people? What if somebody says yes? What if they say maybe? What if they say no? What do you do with those people as you're sorting them into those categories? And how do you do it in such a way that the people who do say yes say, "I can do exactly what you just did," and you can keep that process going? When you master that, you've mastered this business, you're well on your way to having tremendous success. Now, what I want to do right now is just give you a thought process and a goal. And I always want to ask people, especially when they're first getting started, if you're starting any type of business, right? If you're starting any type of business and your business is about earning profit, are you the type of person that wants to leave a bunch of money behind on the table, right? Or would you like to make the money that is available? Well, most people will tell you that if they're starting a business and they're trying to do it for profit, they definitely want to make all the money that's available. So what we've done here in Cerule is we've put together this rank advancement reward system, and it's really very simple. When you're first getting started, you're going to have an opportunity to go out and qualify for a rank called 1K. And it's very simple, right? 1K means you've got $1,000 worth of volume on your team in any calendar month. Okay, 3K is 3,000 in volume, 7.5K is $7,500 in volume. It goes all the way up to 50K. And if you hit these positions, if and when, whenever you hit these positions, we're going to reward you with a rank reward bonus. So you hit the 1K level, we'll give you 50 bucks. You hit the 3K level, we'll give you 100 bucks, et cetera, all the way up to when you hit the 50K level, you're getting $1,000. In fact, when you go through all of these levels, you've earned an additional $2,700 in addition to everything that you've done. However, if you want to take the challenge and you want to actually come out and do this with some speed, you want to go fast, you want to grow, you want to develop momentum very quickly, then we're going to give you bigger and better bonuses. So if you're able to hit the 1K in your first 30 days, right, your first month, if you will, I should say, we're going to give you $100. Okay, so instead of 50, you earn $100. If 1 month after you hit the 1K level, you're able to get to the 3K level, that's a $300 bonus instead of $100. In fact, as you go down, you will see these bonuses get bigger and bigger and bigger. In fact, look at this. If you're able to hit the 50K on this schedule, when you get to the 50K level, we'll give you $5,000 instead of $1,000. In fact, that one bonus at the 50K level is bigger than all the other bonuses combined if you do it on a standard reward track. So you might imagine that going on a fast track rank reward system, that's the best way to maximize your profits, and that's what you want to teach in your team. So we want people focused on that 1K in 30 days. And the easiest way to do it is simply you're started as an IBO, and in your first 30 days into the business, we're going to show you a very simple way how to go out and find a few customers and find a few IBOs of your own. Now, think about it this way. If you actually started off at the fast start level, at the fast start level of 299, and then you found three other people who also saw the value for getting started at that level, well, the 299 all counts as qualifying volume towards your rank. So 299, 299, 299, 299, you've already got more than enough volume to be qualified at the 1K. So we're going to show you how to do this. We're going to show you how to do it fast. And we're going to show you how when you do it and you do it fast, you start creating a culture on your team that as it duplicates, it will take you through all of these levels very quickly. It will help you maximize these bonuses, and it will also help you show other people how to do exactly the same, which is a great thing to do in a business. So take a look at this. If you've actually seen one of our presentation overviews, you've seen this model before. It's a simple theoretical model of how this can actually work with inside of our pay plan, where you find three IBOs like I just showed you on the previous screen. Each one of those IBOs is only responsible for a little bit of volume monthly. So each one is responsible for $200 in volume each. So that's just a very little bit of volume combined times three, that's $600 in volume. Here's your pay percentages that you're earning, and here's the commissions that you earn. And you see that as this grows bigger, as this duplicates over time, it produces a very big number. That's $24,000 per month, month after month, coming into your bank account after this just duplicates through seven levels. But in here, you can also see the value of the business, okay? If you look up here, you notice that in order for you to actually be able to go out and get this started, you got to learn some skills of how to find some people, right? How are you going to find those three IBOs? How are you going to help those three IBOs also find some customers, etc., so we can have some volume going on? And you notice that if you can master those skills, you can get this started, okay? Now, here's the other thing you're going to notice. Even once you do that and you got that going great, we're not talking about a lot of money, you know, 60 bucks a month, $90 a month, not a lot of money. The real money starts to stack up when you start to realize it's not just about what you do, it's what you duplicate. So if you do the business in the way that we're going to teach you, these three people will very easily and very quickly be able to go out and do what you did. That's why it's so critical that you're always following these laws of duplication. So we're not just going to teach you how to get people. We're going to teach you how to get these people in a simple, duplicable way so that your people can go do the same thing. That's critical because as it duplicates, that's where the money starts to stack up. And then finally, you notice that if you're looking to make bigger money, if you're looking to make $5,000 a month or $10,000 a month or $20,000 a month or more, it takes time, right? Even if you're doing everything right, it's not going to happen for you overnight, right? Even if this, if everybody here were doing 1K in 30 days, this would take 7 months. If some people were stretching it out and they were saying, oh, we're not going to do it in 30 days, we're going to do it in 60 days, this would take 14 months. If it was taking people 90 days on average, this would take 21 months. But even if it took people three times as long as what we're projecting, right? If it took you 21 months to get to $24,000 a month, it would still be worth it. But the point is, you'd still have to stick around for that 21 months, right? So what are the things that we can teach you to help you stick around long enough so you understand that time element, so you're not just doing the right stuff, you're not just doing the right stuff in a duplicable way, you're actually applying a time element as well. By the way, remember that definition of success? Large group of people, teach them some simple things that they can repeat consistently over time. It all applies as you start understanding how these things connect together. Now guys, the first thing I want to tell you about this is it can help you become successful if you knew what not to do, right? So I thought it would be important to share with you the two ways that people can fail in this industry. There are really only two ways that you can fail, and I think they're going to make sense to you when you see them. Here's the first way. You don't do the right things, right? That makes sense, doesn't it? I mean, I don't care how good you are at what you're doing. I don't care how often you're doing it. I don't care how strong your work ethic. If you're doing the wrong stuff, not going to have the right result. And that's what we find a lot of times in this industry. People get started. They say, hey, I know what I'm doing. I don't need any teaching. I don't need any training. I got it. I've been a superstar all my life. I'm just going to be a superstar here. And they come in and they go and they start doing things because those things feel right to them. Those things are comfortable for them. Those things buy into their own level of talent. But they don't work because they're the wrong things. So what we're going to ask you to do right here is to avoid this, be coachable. Okay, just be coachable. I don't care what you've accomplished before. You know, I don't care how successful you've been outside of this industry. In this industry, there are some things that are going to be very different than what you're used to, but we do them for a reason because they duplicate. So be coachable. You know, take the coaching. When we call you up and we say, hey, let's adjust this, let's do it this way, let's do it this way. If you want to try it our way, if you can try it our way for 90 days, you'll never want to do it any other way. I promise you. So be coachable. Here's the best thing you can do. attend all the trainings and all the presentations. By doing that, you're going to learn the business. You know, it's amazing. Sometimes people watch presentations, they watch trainings, they say, man, those presenters, those trainers are really, really good. I wonder how they got so good. They got good by attending a whole ton of presentations and trainings before they were ever trying or attempting to present and train. That's how it works. You watch it, then you do it, and now you can learn it really, and then you start going and teaching it. And that's what they did. So be coachable, attend all the presentations and trainings. That's going to keep you from failing by doing the wrong stuff. Now, here's a second way you can fail. Even if you're doing the right things, you don't do them long enough. You ignore that time component that I just mentioned to you on the previous screen. Okay? You say, hey, I'm going to do the right things for a day or a week, and then I'm going to check my mailbox and see if I'm rich. And if I'm not rich, then I'm going to go do the things I wanted to do anyway. Right? I'm going to stop listening to them. I'm going to stop being coachable. Remember, even if you're doing the right things, there's a time element here that is very critical. I love this quote. It says, the first part of success is get-to-itiveness, but the second part of success is stick-to-itiveness. In other words, even if you're getting to it and doing the right stuff, you still got to do it long enough. So I ask every single one of you that's brand new here in Cerule, make a commitment right now that you're going to be here a year from now. If you think about it, that's not a big commitment, right? Who starts a business that you plan on failing or dropping out of in the first year? Why even start that business? So if you can commit to be here a year from now, doing the things that we're teaching you, I can tell you that you are going to be wildly successful here in Cerule if you can just commit to be here a year from now doing the things that we teach you. So two ways to fail: you don't do the right things, so be coachable, you can avoid that. You don't do them long enough, just stick around for a year doing the things we teach you. You can avoid that. You wipe out these two ways to fail, you're going to be successful here with Cerule. Now, the next thing is this. I want you to remember where you are right now. You just got started. You may be very excited, but as far as this business goes, you don't know a lot. And there's a lot you're going to learn. In fact, by the end of this training, you're going to know a lot more than what you knew but at the beginning of this training. But you're at a low level of knowledge as far as this business goes, and you're at a higher level of anxiety, largely because you're at a low level of knowledge. That's how it really works, right? You don't know a lot, so everything is weird. If I say, hey, go pick up the phone, I want you to call somebody that you probably call every single day, but I want you to invite them to take a look at a presentation, all of a sudden you have some anxiety about that. All of a sudden the phone weighs 1,000 pounds, and the reason why is because you're worried that they might start asking you questions. You don't know how to answer those questions. You don't want to make a mistake. You want to do it properly, so you have this anxiety. So low level of knowledge, high level of anxiety, that is the perfect formula for frustration. And we know that if you stay frustrated long enough, you're going to quit. So our goal right now is to raise your knowledge as quickly as we can, thus lowering your anxiety as quickly as we can, so you get out of this frustration model and we can keep you around long enough to embark on that time element that we talked about where you can have big time success. So I know even in this training, we're hitting you with a lot of different concepts, and I don't care if you understand them all fully. I just want you to understand more than anything else that there's a plan. Because if you get that there's a plan, that we really know what we're doing, this is not accidental. This is not, hey, you just join, we pat you on the back, good luck, go figure it out on your own. This is a systemic way for you to become wildly successful in this company. If you get just that level of knowledge can reduce some of your anxiety. It can take you out of frustration. You can stick around long enough, and you can have some tremendous success there. So we want to boost your knowledge, lower your anxiety as quickly as we can, so you can have a better chance of being successful. Now, you've heard this word over and over and over again already on purpose: duplication, duplication, duplication. Here's what I want you to understand. This is all about duplication. Remember, it's not about what you do. You remember that model, that three getting three. It's about what you duplicate. That's the only thing that matters. So if you're doing things, even if they work well for you because you have a certain level of talent, if they can't duplicate, you're not going to be successful in this model. Because systems duplicate, but talent does not. We know we have some talented people that come to the table, some people who may have broken sales records working for corporate America. We have people who have been in Toastmasters for 20 or 25 years. We have all these super talented people coming to the table, and you're so used to using those talents because when you go work out in corporate America, they say, hey, bring all your talents to the table, be as unique as you can, and that's going to actually be rewarding for you. Well, here, it's not. Here, uniqueness is not going to be rewarded because uniqueness doesn't duplicate. Remember, systems duplicate, talent does not. So I'm going to make a deal with you right now. I'm going to show you a systemic way that you can duplicate your way to a very big paycheck. That's my part of the equation. Your part of the equation is once you get that big paycheck, you can be as unique as you want to and how you spend it. In fact, I want to see how you spend it. I hope you post it all over Facebook, you know, all over social media, all the unique ways that you are spending your Cerule income. That is awesome. But we're not going to get that big paycheck so you can have all that unique spending fun unless you buy into the concept of duplication and remember that systems duplicate and talent does not. It's he or she who can actually operate the fastest copy machine that's going to have the fastest success in this type of business. So remember that. This next thing is geometric growth, not linear growth. This is a killer for most people. It is a killer for most people because we've been programmed our entire adult lives to actually think in terms of linear growth and linear paychecks. That's all we do, right? You work an hour, you get paid for an hour. You work a week, you get paid for a week. Work a month, get paid for a month. In fact, let me give you an example right now. If I said to you right now, hey, you're looking at this training for the first time, you're just getting started here in Cerule, and if you do all the things that I'm telling you to do, you can make $120,000 your first year in Cerule. Most of you watching this right now would be happy. You'd say, wow, $120,000 in my first year, I'm in. I am in. I will do exactly what you tell me to do. And that would be great. Now, here's where the poison of the linear mindset starts seeping in almost immediately. Because already, while I've been talking since I said $120,000 in your first year, many of you have already broken that down. It's 120 grand a year. That means 10,000 a month. That means $2,500 a week. Wow, I'm going to make $2,500 my first week here in Cerule. That is awesome. I'm going to be able to walk away from my full-time job. So therefore, because you're thinking in that linear mindset, you're going to do everything that I ask you to do. You're going to stay true to your word. You're going to go out at the end of your first week, and you might make $100. And right away, something's wrong. It doesn't add up in your linear mind. He said 120 grand a year, which is to me would be 10 grand a month, which to me would be 2,500 a week. I made $100. What's wrong? Something's not working. And many of you right there will run into a wall. And maybe if you can break through that wall, you'll say, I don't know. Something went wrong. Maybe I wasn't paying attention well enough. I'm going to do it for one more week. And you'll go out the next week. And not only do you not make $100, you might only make $75 or $50 in the second week. And you're like, okay, something's wrong. I don't know. We're off schedule. It should be $2,500 a week because I want to make $10,000 a month so I can make $120,000 a year. And right then, you put up a wall. You stop doing what I'm asking you to do. And you decide you're going to go do something else because obviously I don't know what I'm talking about. And obviously, the way that you always wanted to do things anyway, that's going to be better for you. Guys, the problem is, you have a linear mindset and not a geometric mindset. Let me show you the difference. You know, there was an old thing that they used to ask people in the early days of the industry. They said, listen, if I give you $1 million right now, here's your choice. I'll give you $1 million right now, or I'll give you a penny, a magic penny that doubles every day for 30 days. Which one would you take? And everybody obviously used to say, I take the $1 million, because no way a penny or doubling every day for 30 days would make a difference, right? And it would take the $1 million. But eventually people started to figure out that the answer was take the magic penny. Because a magic penny doubling every day for 30 days would actually work out to be over $5 million. Much better choice than $1 million is $5 million with the magic penny doubling every day. And a lot of people just took that as, hey, okay, so, you know, when you've got this consistent effort, when you got this consistent doubling, when you got this consistent effort, that it can produce amazing, amazing results for you. But other people really missed the lesson. So let me give you the lesson here really quickly. This is geometric growth, not linear growth. This is why geometric growth is so incredibly powerful. And this is the basis of how we actually build a network marketing business with this geometric growth concept, not linear growth. But what a lot of people miss is this. The reason why the penny can actually start on day one and become over $5 million on day 30 is because pennies are not people. Pennies don't have doubt. Pennies don't stop and reflect. Pennies don't have other coins in their family doubting them and stopping them. If a penny was a person, it would almost never get here. Because a penny would say, we tell the penny, hey, just double every day for 30 days, you're gonna be worth $5 million. And the penny just goes out and does it. It says, I'm just gonna double, 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 and it gets to 5 million. A person says, okay, that sounds great. And they go out and they go 5 days, and at the end of 5 days, they say, okay, let's do an evaluation. Wow, I'm only worth 16 cents. There's no way at 16 cents that I'm gonna go out and be $5 million, you know, over the next 25 days more. There's just no way. That just doesn't make any sense, right? So they start doubting themselves. And they want to take time to reflect. They start saying, maybe I'm not doing it right. Maybe I should have been tripling. Maybe I should have been quadrupling. I don't know. Maybe I should change. But if they're diligent, they might go out and do it again for another week and say, oh my God, I'm only worth 512. That's not right. There's no way I can do this. There's no way I can do this. On day 11, your spouse chimes in. What are you doing? What are you doing? This doesn't work. You're not going to be worth $5 million. You should have taken the million. What are you doing? You're stupid. On day 12, your friends kick in. What are you doing? You're stupid. You're crazy. And by day 13, you probably give up and quit. That's what a person would do. The penny just keeps going. Now, let me show you how this actually applies in our business. We tell you that there's some activities that you should do on a daily basis that are going to help you build massive, massive success in the business. Here's a perfect one. 2 to 3 exposures a day. If you do 2 to 3 exposures a day, and that just becomes your daily habit, 2 to 3 exposures with a third-party tool and consistent follow-up will build you a massive business. That is an absolute fact that's been proven time and time and time again in this industry. But you go out and you start doing it, and after your first week, you're like, wow, I'm not rich yet. I don't know. Maybe this doesn't work. A lot of people are saying no. I'm getting very few yeses. I don't know. Maybe there's a better way to do this. So you start doing it again for a second week, and you're like, I'm not rich yet. I don't know. And that's exactly what happened. See, the penny wouldn't think about that. The penny understands that success is when you can move from failure to failure with no loss in enthusiasm, which means it doesn't matter how many no's you get. It doesn't matter how many down days you have. You just keep doing the same activity over and over and over again with the same level of enthusiasm. You keep doubling every single day, and you're worth over $5 million. The penny gets that. A person doesn't get that. So that's where we have to get you to, is to understand it's about geometric growth, not linear growth. The other lesson here that a lot of people miss is that we offered you $1 million today, or a penny that doubled every day for 30 days. But if you look at this number, you say, wow, the penny went from a penny in day one to over $1 million on day 30. But what a lot of people miss is this. The penny did not eclipse the $1 million mark until day 28. So for 27 days, the vast majority of this time, you were still short in comparison to $1 million. So for 27 days, you got doubt creeping in. You got self-evaluation creeping in. Am I doing it wrong? Did I make a mistake? Are all my friends right? Is my spouse right? Is all these things are creeping in on you that are slowing you down because everybody else is on this linear mindset and you're trying hard to be on a geometric mindset, but it's hard when the geometric mindset doesn't prove itself until later in the game. If I told you I could show you a way to make $120,000 your first year if you just did everything that I said, the reality is the vast majority of that money you would make in the last 3 or 4 months of the year. By the end of the year, you'd still have the 120K. But at the beginning of the year, you'd have a slow buildup, slow buildup, slow buildup as we were building momentum, building duplication until it exploded. And before you got to that explosion, when you're somewhere up in here, it's real easy to question what we're saying. Don't. Whenever you start questioning it, whenever you're saying, man, this is taking a little bit longer, I thought that it was going to be a different kind of pace, just remember that penny doubling. Just keep doubling, okay? The big money comes later in the equation, but when it comes, look at what happens. It explodes, and you definitely have made the right decision. 2 to 3 exposures a day or any other daily activity we're talking about is going to produce the results that you're looking for. Guys, this is a big one here. The road to failure versus the road to success. Here's the numbers. These aren't my numbers. These are the government numbers. You can look them up. And here's how they work. 95% of all the people in our society are going to fail by the time that they retire. 95%. 95% financially, by the way. I'm not saying they're a failure in life. They're bad people. They're crazy. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying 95% of the people are going to be financially dependent on friends, family, and the federal government by time they retire. Only 5% will have created financial freedom by the time they retire. 95 versus 5. If you're getting into this business, you're trying to be part of the 5%. You're trying to walk the road to success. Well, as you can see, that would be the road less traveled, right? If 95% of the people are walking this road to failure from a financial standpoint. The other way of looking at that is it's 19 versus 1. For every one of you on this road, there's 19 people on that road. And most of those 19 people are family, friends, coworkers, neighbors. And guess what? When they are on this road and they look over and they see you lonely by yourself over on this road, they're not going to say, oh, John must have figured something out. Let's go get on the road with him. Quite the opposite. They're going to say, John, what are you doing over there by yourself? What are you, crazy? Get over here with us. There's safety in numbers. Listen, you think you're smarter than the collective 19 of us? Get over here with us. You're crazy. What are you doing? And you're going to hear all sorts of pushback. And it's not for them being negative. They actually think they're protecting you. You're walking down this lonely road all on your own. What could happen to you? Guys, this is one of the times that you don't want to be with the masses. This is one of those times that you want to be on this road, and you have to remember that. Literally, if somebody's not telling you that you're crazy, if they're not saying, I can't believe you're doing one of those things, I can't believe you're doing that, then you are doing something wrong. Because I promise you, at some point, if you're doing this right, one of the 19 is going to try to protect you and try to get you onto the other road. However, getting on that other road will be taking you down a direction that you don't want to go down. So I will tell you this, one more, a little piece of wisdom, another piece of wisdom from Napoleon Hill and from Think and Grow Rich. He said, listen, after interviewing these 500 most successful people in the world, they all pretty much agreed the number one reason that people fail, they listen to advice from their friends and family. I want you to think about that. Again, we love our friends and family, and they love us, which is why they're giving the advice. They don't know they're walking down this road. That's not their intention. They're just doing what their parents told them to do, whose parents told them what to do, etc. So they don't know any better. Once you know better, don't fall into the trap of listening to the masses. Keep doing what you're doing. You're going to be way ahead of the curve in terms of being successful. Next thing, guys, is this whole concept of a workout partner. This is critical. This is going to help you stay motivated long term, right? It's got to be a person that you share similar goals with. Again, if you want to make $100 a month and I want to make $100 a day, we're not on the same wavelength in terms of goals. I'm trying to accomplish something a lot bigger, so I'm going to actually have to work and push myself a lot harder. So you want to have somebody that you have similar goals with. Now, this is going to be somebody that you trust and that you can communicate with daily, and you can have daily honest communication. Because at the end of every day, you're going to ask them, and they're going to ask you, hey, what'd you do today? You know, what'd you do today to forward your business? Did you do your 2 to 3 exposures today? Did you help a brand new IBO go through their game plan review process? Did you do this? Did you do that? And you got to be honest about it. You know, you got to say to yourself, if you didn't do it, you got to say, no, I didn't do it. I woke up this morning. It was raining outside. I didn't feel like going for a run. So I slouched off. You got to be honest about it. And when you tell them that, they're going to get you back on pace. Same way. The other way, you're going to have some great days where they're going to have some down days, and you're going to get them back on pace as well. And the final thing is you got to know each other's why, okay? If they know that the reason why you're doing the business is because you want to pay your kids' college education in 2 years, and you all of a sudden say, I had a bad day today, 4 people said no, I don't know if I'm doing the right thing, and they say to you, well, you're going to let those 4 no's stand between you and John Jr.'s college education, all of a sudden it's clarified in your brain that those 4 no's don't matter. That you're going to go back out there just like the penny, and you're going to double tomorrow and double the next day and double the next day, and you're not going to be psychologically attached to the results. You're just going to go out there and get it done. That's what this is all about. In fact, the people who actually have a workout partner, they have 5 times more likely, they're 5 times more likely to reach the top of the pay plan than the people who don't. So this is a critical, critical thing. It's a critical factor. In the beginning, when you're just getting started, you may not know anyone else in the business. So your sponsor can be your de facto workout partner in the beginning. But very quickly, as you start building a team and you start meeting new people who maybe you have more similarly aligned goals, who you know better, maybe you trust even more, maybe you want to work with because you guys are getting started around the same time, you will find your workout partner, and then that's going to be your daily communication that keeps you on track. Now, this next thing is critical, guys. This is really, really deep and really, really serious. You got to understand this about why you want to create a culture of auto ship on your business, in your business, I should say. This is very critical. Number one, you want to be a product of the product, okay? Imagine how ridiculous it would sound for you to go out to the world and tell people, we got the best products in the universe, you definitely want to use them, and somebody says, awesome, what products are you using? And you say, oh, I don't use the products. How crazy does that sound, right? So you need to be a product of the product. You know, you need to actually take these products every single day. That's what they were designed for, daily consumption. Take them every single day. Keep your own personal health optimized so you can be a product of the product. Number two is you want to build your own belief in your own story. I know a lot of you got started here because you heard about some incredible story of what these products did for someone else. Maybe it was a good friend of yours. Maybe it was a family member, a coworker, someone like that. And you said, wow, that's amazing. If those products are that awesome, I got to have them. And you know what? I know a lot of people who could use them. I'm going to go out and I'm going to market them as well. But your real belief doesn't happen until you have your own story, right? As that starts to happen, as you start to feel the changes in your own body, you start to recognize some of the differences in your own body, that's when your true belief builds up. Now, here's how it works in this business. You can only build this business to the level of your belief. So if you got a small belief, small paycheck. Bigger belief, bigger paycheck. Massive belief, massive paycheck. And part of you getting from a small little belief to a massive belief is you having your own experience here. So build your own belief in your own story. You want to take these products all the time. Finally, there's this thing called personal auto ship volume for commissions, okay? So I don't want to get into a deep pay plan training. We're going to do a separate training where we talk about the pay plan. But just understand, as you go through the ranks, we talked about those ranks earlier, right? 1K, 3K, 7.5K, et cetera. As you're going up through ranks, right, there's a personal volume requirement for you to be able to be qualified at those ranks. Now, you can do it through personal autoship volume, or you can do it through some combination of the orders that you're making personally as well as what your customers are doing. Here's what I'll tell you. If it's personal autoship volume, the requirements are lower. If it's going through all of your volume combined with the customers, the requirements are higher. So I would always suggest you go through their personal auto ship volume. So $50, $100, $150, or $200 in volume, okay, from a personal auto ship level will make sure you're able to qualify all the way through the ranks. As the ranks go higher, the personal auto ship volume level goes higher as well. But this will make sure that you're always qualified and that you never miss a check. I've missed a check before because I wasn't on auto ship. It happened a long time ago. It only needed to happen once. It never happened again. It's a painful experience. I don't want you to go through it. Make sure that you're always having the proper auto ship to make sure you qualify for the check. Now, here's the final reason, and this is a big, big reason if you really think about this. Remember, you're a Cerule IBO, independent business owner. So you're getting the very best pricing that you can get on the products, the very best pricing. So let's say we're going to look at Stem Enhance Ultra. As an IBO with Cerule, Stem Enhance Ultra is going to cost you $60 if you're just ordering it, ordering it once a month. You're just going to order it. You're not on auto ship. You're just going to order it separately. It's going to cost you $60. You get $50 worth of qualifying volume, which means this is going to help you qualify for ranks, right? This is how they determine how much volume you have in terms of rank qualification and advancement. And you get $50 worth of commissionable volume. Now, this is the number you want to focus on because this determines how you get paid, right? Remember when we were talking about 10% or 7% or 5% throughout the unit level, right? Well, this determines how you actually get paid. So for every bottle, it's going to be worth $50 of commissionable volume, and you'll get paid your requisite percentage off of that $50. Now, look what happens if you go on auto ship. First of all, it's cheaper. Now you're getting the same exact product for $5 less. So now you're saving money. But more importantly, they're going to give you a 10% boost for qualifying volume and commissionable volume. So now instead of it only being worth $50 worth of volume, it's worth $55. So you're paying less money, but it qualifies you faster for ranks. You're paying less money, but they're paying you more money. You just got a 10% raise. So in theory, if you had an entire team, let's say you had an entire team of people, thousands of people, and everybody was only ordering one bottle of Stem Enhance Ultra every single month, right, in this theoretical team, and they're all ordering it from a month-to-month standpoint, they're not doing it on auto ship, they're paying more money, they're qualifying slower, and they're earning slower. If you just got everybody to switch over to auto ship, they save money, they all qualify ranks faster, and they're all getting a 10% increase in their paychecks. That is how you need to think about auto ship. You should get it, you should keep it, and you should duplicate it. Every single person on your team that is serious about building a business should be on auto ship, and they should never let it go. If you do this, you're just really maximizing the compensation structure. Now, the next thing, the grand opening, right? Name one business that you would start and you wouldn't tell anybody that you started. It wouldn't make sense, right? How would people even know that you were in business? So you want to have a grand opening. Here we call it a private business reception. And I don't care. I know normally in better times, right, we would do these all face-to-face. We'd invite some people over to our house or to our office or somewhere that they were comfortable and they associated with us. If we owned a small business already, we might invite them there. But guys, right now, for what we're doing, we can still do these types of things through a Zoom call. Or we can do it on a webinar, or you can do them on a conference call. If you say, hey, listen, my crowd of people, they're not very internet savvy. They don't all have computers. I'm sure they all have phones though, right? So you could still do a conference call. It doesn't matter. This is just, you just got started in a business, and in your first 7 to 10 days, when you're at your highest level of enthusiasm, you're very excited, we want to invite some people to our private business reception, a private gathering where we're going to have an expert go over the products and the business opportunity, an abbreviated point for them, and see if they can help you out getting your business launched off of the ground. You're just letting them know what you're doing. And we're very transparent about it. We invite these people and we say, hey, listen, I'm having a private business reception, just started a new business. I'm super excited about it and I want you to take a look at it. And I want to be transparent with you up front. I'm hoping you can help me out in one of three ways. You know, I'm going to have an expert who's going to be present, who's going to actually do a very brief presentation about it. And some of you right away, you're going to see what I see. You're going to see that these products are something that everybody needs from a standpoint of maximizing their health. And you're going to want to try the products. And in that way, you can help my business out by being one of my new customers. Awesome. Some of you, however, are going to see exactly what I saw, which is that this is a way for you to handle some of your financial desires, some of the things you're going to get done. As most of you know, I was worried about paying for my son's college education. I'm pretty sure now, and I'm pretty confident now, though, that with this business model, I'm going to be able to get that knocked out. Maybe you've got some big things you want to accomplish as well. And if you see it here, you're going to actually say, hey, let's partner up and let's be business partners together. And that will be awesome as well. And the third way is maybe you're not interested right now in the products for yourself or the opportunity for yourself, but you probably know someone who might be open and interested, and I would appreciate the referral. So customers, business partners, or referrals, either way you can help me would be awesome, but I need you to actually be present to see what I'm doing so you can help me in one of those ways. So can I count on you? It's a simple thing, but I promise you this. Imagine how powerful it is when you're able to do one of these PBRs 7 to 10 days in. First of all, in 7 to 10 days, nobody's going to be asking you crazy questions like, well, how much money have you made? And how rich are you, right? They know you've only been doing it for 7 to 10 days, right? So they don't expect any of that. You're just getting started. This is your first big launch. So they're here to support you, and they're not drilling you with how has it worked, how has it worked. So that's not going to happen. In fact, they might ask the expert, and the expert can tell them their story about how it's worked for them and the people that they worked with. The second thing is, right out of these PBRs, we can get you to 1K. Very often, you're going to be able to get your 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 IBOs. You're going to be able to get your few customers right out of these PBRs. So right away, you have one of these 7 to 10 days, boom, you can walk out of this as 1K, right? So you're already getting all those bonuses from being 1K. But then here's where it gets better. Right out of your PBR, we schedule additional PBRs. The new IBOs that get started there, we say, listen, we want to do one of these for you. And you saw how it worked. It was very easy. It was an easy invitation. You didn't have to do much. You sat back. You let the expert do all the presenting, all the work, and then people decided how they wanted to help out, way one, way two, or way three. Hey, we could do one of these for you in 7 to 10 days. And right out of there, you could schedule another 3 or 4 or 5, PBRs. So 10 days later, 7 days later to 10 days later, you have another 4 or 5. And then out of there, we can schedule another group of 4 or 5 for each one of those people. So maybe you had another 15, 20, 25 happening. And think about that story. You would be able to say 30 days later, you say, hey, I got started 30 days ago. All I did was have one of these. A few people got started at mine. And then we went out and had a few for them 7 to 10 days later. Several people got started at each one of them. Now we're here 30 days later. And guys, I've already got 30 people on my team. I've already hit 1K, 3K, 7.5K. I've hit them on these fast track bonuses. I'm just getting started here, but we can duplicate this model all day, every day. And that keeps the momentum going. In fact, just doing this alone, just building a culture of private business receptions is going to build a big business for you. But remember, we have to start with yours. So let's get yours booked. You started the business today or you started yesterday. 7 to 10 days from today, we want to have a private business reception for you as a grand opening launch to your business. Now, personal development, and then we're going to wrap up here, guys. And this is really simple. You know, it's interesting. Abraham Lincoln said, if I had 6 hours to chop down a tree, I'd spend the first 4 hours sharpening the axe. And that was metaphorical. What he just basically meant was, if I had to, you know, take on a big task, I would spend more time working on me than working on it. And metaphorically, this is the problem that we've seen in the business. You know, people, they come here, they want to be amazingly successful. They want to make these big giant checks. They want to accomplish these big giant goals. But they don't want to do, they don't want to change themselves. They don't want to change the axe. So when I say take the same axe, the same dull axe that hasn't worked to accomplish big goals before, and they want to start whacking away at these big giant goals, and then they're going to get frustrated and say, well, this doesn't work. Well, it's not. Remember that U factor. Remember the U factor, right? This is how you improve on the U factor is personal development. Guys, if you want to chop down a big goal, chop down a big tree in this scenario, you want to sharpen your axe, sharpen your axe, sharpen your axe, sharpen your mind. You want to personally develop. You want to realize something that's critical. The person who's going to join Cerule is not going to be the same person who's going to be making 10 grand a month or 20 grand a month or 30 grand a month or more later. That person who earns those levels of income, you will be completely different than who you were when you started. You will be completely personally developed. a personally developed version of yourself, a better version of yourself because of what you're going to go through here. So here's a few ways to work on personal development right away. 10 pages of a good book every single day. Think about that for a moment. How long does it take you to read 10 pages of a book? 10, 15, 20 minutes, right? Max, right? 10 pages of a good book a day. 365 days in a year. If you read 10 pages of a good book a day, even if you took some days off, right? That could still be over 3,000 pages that you would read. How many books is that, right? 10 good books, 15 good books. Imagine what you would look like, what you would think like if you read 15 books over this year coming that were all about how to be better at business, how to understand the psychology of people better, how to go out and maximize yourself, how to build these teams better. If you read 15 books like that over the next 12 months, you would not be the same person that you are today, nor would your check reflect it. Your check would reflect a new version of yourself who went through that, and all you did was 10 pages per day, even taking some days off. You'd still be over 3,000 pages. Because when you're driving to work or driving your kids to school or any of that stuff, hey, you don't have to listen to music. You can turn it to Drive Time University. You can get your 10 minutes, 15 minutes of personal development in there while you're driving in your car. And oh, by the way, attend all presentations and trainings. That's how you're going to learn this business. That's how you're going to learn how to present it. That's how you're going to learn how to train it. That's how you're going to really embrace some of these concepts is you're attending all the presentations and trainings. Remember, daily personal development. You don't have to do a lot any single day, but if you're consistent about it, it's like everything else. That consistency adds up. That geometric principle kicks in, that penny doubling kicks in, even with your personal development. And over the course of time, you will become an amazing version of yourself and you will be an absolute killer in this business. Guys, one of the final concepts I want to share with you is right here, and it's very critical that you understand this, because I think if you understand this, it's going to put you in a much better position to be successful. I remember I learned a long time ago that when a space shuttle was actually being launched up into space, it was using up 90% of its fuel. You see all the fire coming out, all the smoke going all over the place, all the fuel being burned. It used up 90% of its fuel to get just 10 feet off the ground. And I thought that was so amazing, right? Because it's going far, right? It's going all the way to space, miles and miles and miles and miles and up, right? But just to get 10 feet off the ground, it had to use 90% of its fuel. And I thought that was incredible because I said, wow, it's still going all the way to space. So 10% of the fuel left is enough to get it all the way up to space, enough to have it go out, complete its mission, and enough for it to land safely, which I thought was pretty incredible. But when you look at the physics of it, you really start to understand it. It's actually simple. You got this big, giant space shuttle. It's very, very heavy, right? And you've got the downward force of gravity acting against the mass of the space shuttle. And it needs to create enough upward thrust to create what they call escape velocity. Now, what's interesting is once you create escape velocity, once you're able to overcome the downward push of gravity, then you're kind of on cruise control. Now, you don't need as much fuel. Now you're just kind of drifting, right? And now that 10% is more than enough to get it all the way up to space, complete its mission, and land safely. So what does that have to do with network marketing? Well, guys, think about this for a moment. Imagine you were that NASA astronaut. You were training to fly the space shuttle. You were top of your class. You were learning every single lesson that you needed to learn. But the day they covered that one thing I just said, 90% of the fuel to get 10 feet off the ground, the day they covered that one thing, you were in the bathroom. You had to go to the bathroom. So you missed that one thing. You know everything else about the space shuttle. And now you're in the space shuttle, and it's go time. It's mission day. And it's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off. And you get about 9.5 to 10 feet off the ground, and you are sitting there watching your fuel needle go down from 100% to 90 to 80 to 70 to 60, all the way down to 10%, and you realize you're only 10 feet off the ground. What do you think you're going to do? Yep, you're going to abort the mission. You're going to parachute out of that baby, and by the time you land in the water, and when people pull you out of the water and say, what the heck was that? Why'd you abort the mission? You're going to say, man, I don't know what was going on. We must have had a fuel leak or something, because we were only 10 feet off the ground, and we had lost 90% of the fuel. And when they explain to you that that's the way it's supposed to work, you're going to feel a little foolish, and you're going to say, man, I shouldn't have quit. I shouldn't have aborted the mission. I should have stayed along for the ride, and I would have got my big goal of getting up to space. Well, that's how network marketing works. And I wish more people understood this right at the beginning. You see, we're throwing a lot at you. This training is a lot. I know it's a lot of stuff. That's why it's video and you can watch it over and over and over again. But what's interesting is you're going to hear a lot of things in the very beginning. Remember, we're trying to get your knowledge up, your anxiety down, right? So you don't get frustrated, you don't quit. So we're hitting you with some things, and you're like, man, I got to go out there, I got to have a PBR, and then I got to invite people to my PBR, and then I got to, you know, line up with the expert, and I got to figure out this penny doubling thing, and I got to stop thinking as a linear guy, start thinking as a geometric guy. All these things are happening, and you're like, man, I got to go through all this, and I go through all that just to get a few people. Just to get a few people. And then you go back and you look at that chart about where the big money is. You say, man, I want to be one of those guys making $24,000 a month. And you say, man, oh my God, it takes thousands and thousands and thousands of IBOs on my team and thousands and thousands and thousands of customers ordering these bottles every month for me to make $24,000 a month. And I just went through an incredible learning curve and a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of fuel. Just to get three people, just to get 10 feet off the ground. There's no way that I have enough energy, enough fuel to get thousands of people on my team. But what you don't understand is that escape velocity in our business is momentum created through duplication. So that even though you're going through and you're spending all this fuel to not only learn how to do this business, but to do it the right way that duplicates, and you feel like you're spending a lot of energy to learn it and then to ultimately do it, once you create duplication through momentum, well, you get escape velocity in your business. And then your big giant goal, your big giant dream that you're trying to accomplish, taking it all the way up to space, now it's just on cruise control. Now you can get all the way up there, complete your mission, you can come down and land safely because we've created that duplication through momentum. So guys, don't abort the mission. Even though you feel like you spent a lot of energy in the beginning, that's how it's supposed to work. I promise you, if you do it our way, you expend that energy in the beginning just to get those few people, but get them the right way, which means in a way that they say right away, I can do what you did, and they can go out and duplicate you quickly. You can build up momentum through duplication, and you can accomplish your goal very easily here with the Cerule Pay Plan. So guys, finally, here it is. This is your business, 10 core commitments. If I were you, I would freeze this screen right now. I would write these down, and I would put these on my wall wherever I'm going to be doing business at, in my house or in my private office or whatever. Make sure that everybody on your team, from this point on, every new IBO has a game plan interview. Even if you're brand new and you don't feel like you can conduct a game plan interview, get with your sponsor and have them conduct it for you. You just watch and learn, and then eventually you'll be able to do it. But even if you just get them to watch this training that you just watched right now, have everybody go through the game plan interview process. Make sure that everybody on your team automatically, 7 to 10 days from the time they're getting started, has a PBR or a private conference call. You know, they do something, a Zoom call, a webinar, a conference call, some way of launching their business to their closest contacts who they love, trust, and respect, and who love, trust, and respect them, so you can actually get it out there right away. I'm in business. This is what I'm doing. Do you want to be a customer? Do you want to actually become an IBO with me? Or do you want to provide referrals of some people who might? That's going to be the fast way to launch your business and the fast way to duplicate your business. Make sure that you and everybody on your team who's joining is focused on 1K in 30. Because if everybody's focused on it, it doesn't even matter if everybody gets it done. If everybody's focused on it, they're duplicating the proper activities, you're going to have quick growth in your business. You're going to create escape velocity very quickly. You're going to have momentum created, and that's going to actually go towards building a big business, big check, big rewards for you and your family. After that's done, that's how you launch your business. Then you're into the daily method of operations. You're going to go out and expose 1 to 3 people a day. Okay, that's that penny doubling. You're not going to be worried about it, how many yeses you get or any of that kind of stuff. Don't worry. You'll get better at it because you'll get into a rhythm, right? You're going to attend all weekly presentations, attend all trainings like the one you're on right now. You're going to stay on autoship. Remember, we talked about that. Best way to give yourself a 10% raise and to qualify for your ranks 10% faster. You're going to get yourself a workout partner right away. Okay, you're going to practice daily personal development so you don't even recognize yourself a year from now, right? Because you're going to be that much more developed, and you're going to be here a year from now. Now, here's the deal. You're not just going to be here a year from now. You're not going to disappear for the next 365 days and pop up and say, I've been here a year. Where's my millions at, right? You're going to be here a year from now doing all of these things. Imagine what your team and your business and your paycheck would look like if everybody on your team had a game plan interview, launched their business, focused on 1K in 30, was exposing 1 to 3 people a day, attended all the presentations, trainings, got on autoship, got a workout partner, and was practicing daily personal development for a year straight. Everybody doing these things. They're doing the right things, and they're doing them long enough, right? What is your business going to look like? What is your future going to look like? It's going to be absolutely tremendous. So to wrap this up, guys, write down your why. Share it with your sponsor. Let them know what your big reason why is you're doing this business. Schedule your first PBR. Get on autoship if you're not currently on autoship. As soon as you're done this training, go log into your back office and get on autoship. Learn the details of becoming 1K in 30 so you can focus on that and get it done. Very often we're going to get that done for you in your PBR anyway. Start your daily personal development. You know, there's a lot of great books you can read, right? You can read Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. I talked about that here. GoPro by Eric Worre, etc. Some great books that you can read. Find your workout partner and learn and follow the core commitments. With that being said, I want to thank you guys for joining us here with the Game Plan Interview. I hope you found this helpful, and I look forward to seeing you on future trainings. Have a great day, and look forward to celebrating your success.